the crew, Mr. Faulkner. We sail for Chesapeake Bay.
Lafayette promised me a fleet beyond compare and a captain without peer. Instead, I find myself greeted by one old ship and a boy in costume.
I promise we are all you need, Admiral.
I doubt this very much, but beggars do not choose.
And the ships I require?
They are yours, provided we survive this.
What would you have me do?
Hold the bay while I engage the main fleet. Should any British ships dare approach, destroy them. They must be kept from Yorktown.
Fire!
to this headwind, Captain!
Mind up those sails! sir.
My God. Where are our blasted reinforcements?
They will come. We must hold the bay until they do.
Oh, this is madness. You're alone and we're without reinforcements.
Careful, Captain.
A poor child, Christ! Man of war's on us!
We're under attack! Man of war's firing!
All our guns are down. There's no way to defend ourselves now. A beast is sure to sink us if we're not careful.
Fire, Skipper! Sorry, Skip!
He's not really planning to board them, is he? Has he lost his mind? Who's going to get us all killed?
I need less! Switch your shot!
They say you took down that man of war all alone. Perhaps Lafayette did not exaggerate when he spoke of your abilities. As promised, my ships are yours to command. What do you require?
Five of them must enter New York's harbor flying British flags.
Wait, wait. I thought you might need some pirates killed or goods transported, and instead, you asked for us to, what, shell New York?
No. Of course not.
Ah.
Only part of it.
Explain yourself.
I mean to infiltrate Fort George, but it is too well guarded. Cannon fire will breach its walls and scatter its guards.
And a ship that flies the French flag could never get near it.
You understand, then?
Not at all. But a promise is a promise, even when made to a lunatic.
I will light a signal fire when it is time for you to attack.
Vous l'avez entendu. Récupérez leurs drapeaux qu'on puisse les accrocher. Allez, vite!
Hello, Gunner. Welcome back.
Is everything in place?
Oui. Lafayette waits for you inside the tunnel beneath the city.
Connor! This tunnel will take you into the military district.
And the Admiral?
He waits for you to light the signal. And then, the strike begins.
And we will be there as well.
I will.
I'll turn you off! Get back here, you deaf turd!
To fight. Need to stay away from the guards.
Where are you, Charles?
Gone.
Match me, Connor.
With all your skills, you are still but a boy, with so much left to learn.
Give me Lee!
Impossible. He is the promise of a better future. A sheep need a shepherd.
He has been dismissed and censured. He can do nothing for you now.
A temporary setback. He will be restored.
And yet everything I've shown you, all
I've said and done should clearly demonstrate otherwise. Wait!
Surrender, and I will spare you.
Brave words from a man about to die.
You fare no better.
Even when your kind appears to triumph, still we rise again. And you know why? It's because the Order is born of a realization. We require no creed, no indoctrination by desperate old men. All we need is that the world be as it is. This is why the Templars will never be destroyed. Don't think I have any intention of caressing your cheek and saying I was wrong. I will not weep and wonder what might have been. I'm sure you understand. Still, I'm proud of you in a way. You've shown great conviction, strength, courage. All noble qualities. I should have killed you long ago.
We've got a problem. Haytham doesn't have the amulet anymore.
But the temple's still sending data. There must be more to the story.
Only one way to find out.
My father is dead. Charles Lee now leads the Templar Order in his place. I see now why ours is an eternal war. For each piece taken from the board, another is placed upon it. Back and forth we go, across the world, across the ages. Some days mine feels an impossible task, but I cannot afford to be consumed with doubt. The people need me. Now more than ever. I must stop the Templars. I will kill Charles Lee.